Thanks for choosing to list your home with Hauseit. In this video, we will walk you through what happens next. But first, let us more formally introduce ourselves. Hauseit was founded here in New York City in 2014. Since then, we've helped over 1,000 homeowners like yourself save money on real estate commissions. We've listed over $1 billion of real estate here in New York City, Long Island, and the Hudson Valley. Along the way, we've received hundreds of positive reviews. In conclusion, the service you're using is not new or experimental, but rather a time-tested and proven way of selling and saving money. That being said, the sale process itself is never easy or straightforward, even when you use our service. Even in the best of markets, the average time it takes for a listing to enter contract in New York City is approximately 4 months. And keep in mind that this average time frame is for traditional, full-service listings with professional photos and experienced listing agents who are overseeing the process. So it's important to walk into this endeavor with the understanding that success with our assisted FSBO listing service requires patience, perseverance, and effort. Most importantly, you will only succeed if you do your homework and learn the specifics of how the process works. At Hauseit, we've created over 1,000 detailed articles and videos which cover just about every part of the sale process in great detail. We encourage you to learn about the various steps of the process before you find yourself wondering what to do next. This will maximize your chances of a successful outcome. Here are some things you can learn by checking out our articles and videos on the Hauseit website. How do I deal with buyer's agents? What documents should I ask for when receiving an offer? How do I deal with multiple offers? How long do I have to respond to an offer? What happens after an offer is accepted? How do I prepare a deal sheet? How much are my closing costs? What's the typical real estate attorney fee? What questions should I ask when interviewing attorneys? At this point, our support team has already uploaded your listing and sent you a notification email. If your property is in New York City, we've also shared with you two links, one from RealtyMX and another from Stratus. RealtyMX shows how your listing appears in the RLS broker database, also known as the REBNY listing service, which is operated by the Real Estate Board of New York. Stratus shows how your listing appears in the OneKey MLS, which is used by agents who are members of HGAR, Hudson Gateway Association of Realtors, and LIBOR, the Long Island Board of Realtors. If your property is in Long Island or the Hudson Valley, we've sent you a link from Stratus, which allows you to view your listing in the OneKey MLS. The complete listing syndication process to all third-party websites takes 24 to 48 hours. During this time, your listing may not appear on all sites, and there may be momentary syndication errors as the listing is finalized. Please refrain from submitting an update request until 48 hours have elapsed from the time you receive this email. If errors persist after 48 hours, please submit a listing update request by visiting hauseit.com/listing-update. You can also access this from the menu bar at hauseit.com. Now let's go over some frequently asked questions. How will I receive inquiries? All email, text message, and voicemail inquiries pertaining to your listing will be forwarded to the email address you designated when submitting your listing details. We use automatic server-level forwarding rules to ensure rapid and automatic transmission of inquiries directly to your email. In addition to our automatic inquiry forwarding technology, our front desk team conducts routine manual checks to ensure that no inquiry is ever missed. During business hours, our front desk personnel will also send you a text message notification to alert you whenever a new listing inquiry is forwarded to your email. For live inbound callers, we partner with call centers across the world to ensure 24/7 coverage of our phone lines. Buyer's agents may request a showing by calling our 24/7 call center at 1-800-746-9464, which is powered by ShowingTime. When an agent calls to request a viewing, you will receive a notification from ShowingTime via email, phone, or text message in order to approve the request. ShowingTime is an industry-leading showing management service which we provide free of charge to our assisted FSBO sellers. ShowingTime assists with coordination and confirmation of appointments, and a ShowingTime account will be created for you within 24 to 48 hours of your listing being uploaded. Once the ShowingTime account is created, you may customize how to receive alerts for showing requests. If a direct buyer or an agent calls our main phone number, 888-494-8258, our front desk team will take a message and forward it to you during normal business hours. How are showings scheduled and handled? Once we loop you in on an initial inquiry via email, our responsibilities end and it's up to you to take it from there. As an assisted FSBO seller, it's up to you to schedule viewings, attend showings, respond to inquiries, negotiate offers, and manage the process from accepted offer through to contract and all the way to closing. Did I receive any inquiries today? We understand that it may be tempting to ask this question, especially in a slow market. Please rest assured that all email, text message, voicemail inquiries, and front desk messages pertaining to your listing will be forwarded to the email address you designate when submitting your listing details. If you're not getting enough traffic, please consider realistically pricing your property in line with comps and ordering professional photography. Please also make sure to set realistic expectations with regard to the duration of the sale process by studying how long it took similar listings in your area to go into contract. The typical time it takes for a listing to enter contract in New York City is approximately 4 months, even in the strongest markets. By definition, this means that on average, you should not expect to be flooded with inquiries the moment you list. Will my contact information appear on the listing? MLS rules prohibit contact info such as phone numbers, emails, or website URLs from being included in your listing description. The contact information on your listing will be that of the listing agent, which is Hauseit. Rest assured, all email, text message, and voicemail inquiries pertaining to your listing will be forwarded to you via email. Once we loop you in on an initial inquiry via email, our responsibilities end and it's up to you to take it from there. How should I represent my role? You can always explain to buyers and buyer's agents that you are taking an active role in your home sale as the owner. You never need to obfuscate your identity. Remember that buyer's agents can see the commission percentage you're offering to them in the OneKey MLS and or the RLS broker database, depending on the region where your listing is located. For buyer agent inquiries, we recommend focusing on scheduling a showing and answering questions instead of flaunting your status as the owner early on. There's simply no upside to bragging about your lower commission arrangement, as it might confuse or turn off buyer's agents who are simply focused on getting their client in to see your apartment or your home. If an initial showing leads to something more substantial, it's okay to explain that you're taking an active role in the process as the owner. What happens after I accept an offer? With your home now receiving maximum exposure, and assuming you've taken professional photographs and priced your property correctly, you'll start seeing inquiries and eventually offers will start to come in. Decide to accept an offer from an unrepresented buyer? Great, you'll pay 0% commission at closing. What if you accept an offer from a purchaser who is represented by a buyer's agent? Well, pay only what you choose to offer to buyer's agents in the broker database. You are free to sell to anyone you choose or to no one at all. It's your call. What's next after you've accepted an offer? Well, the next step is to prepare and send a deal sheet to both attorneys and the buyer's agent, if there is one. If you're selling a condo or co-op, you'll also need to email the building due diligence documents to the purchaser's attorney. These items include the most recent building financials, the offering plan, purchase and sublet applications, house rules, as well as the alteration agreement. We recommend placing these items in a cloud storage folder using a service like Dropbox or Google Drive, and then including that link in the email containing the deal sheet. To avoid any delay in the purchaser signing the contract, we recommend assembling all of this paperwork at the very beginning of the sale process, instead of waiting until you have an accepted offer. Similarly, we also suggest interviewing and selecting a real estate attorney at the beginning of the process, instead of waiting until you've accepted an offer. Visit our website, houseit.com, to learn more about how to interview real estate attorneys, as well as the typical fees they might charge. Keep in mind that an accepted offer is not binding until the purchase contract is fully executed, and the buyer's attorney must review the due diligence documentation before advising her or his client to sign the contract. So any delay caused by not having this documentation readily available might put your deal at risk. If you're unable to locate some or all of these items, please check with your managing agent or a board member. If you're selling a co-op or a condo and the buyer doesn't have a broker, You may also need to help the purchaser assemble and submit the purchase application, and in the case of a co-op, coach the buyer for the co-op board interview. Now, this phase of the deal happens after the contract is signed, and in the case the buyer is financing, after she or he has received a mortgage commitment letter. We also recommend scheduling an introductory consultation with one of our experienced real estate attorneys. You can ask any legal questions you have and learn more about the step-by-step New York City closing process from timing to costs. Can I pay for additional marketing or premium advertising? Yes. Certain third-party websites such as StreetEasy offer premium advertising which you can elect to pay for. For example, StreetEasy offers the ability to feature your listing in search results for a non-refundable fee. While we do not believe paying for such features is necessary nor industry standard, you may request to feature your listing on StreetEasy by submitting a listing update request. Am I allowed to cancel before my listing term expires? Yes. You may discontinue the service at any time, although we strongly encourage you to utilize the full listing term. The average time it takes for new listings to go into contract in New York City is around 4 months. And keep in mind that this estimate does not include the additional 2 or 3 months on average it takes to close on a transaction once you're already in contract. Furthermore, the average days on market for listings above 2 million is significantly higher than 4 months. It can take a year or more to sell certain properties above the 5 million mark or for very unique listings at lower price points. Even if there is nothing wrong with your pricing, photography, and general marketing strategy, canceling prematurely will likely not give your listing enough time, statistically speaking, to find a buyer. Prior to listing, we strongly encourage you to research the average days on market for comparable properties in your area. Assuming you've priced your property in line with the comps and you have professional photos and a floor plan, you should set expectations for similar performance when it comes to the timeline for going into contract with a buyer on your own listing. Keep in mind that general market conditions can change rapidly, so it's always possible that your listing will take longer or even take less time to go into contract compared to recently sold comps. Overpricing your listing, not having a floor plan, or using amateur photos may result in significant underperformance when it comes to the expected timeline for finding a buyer and the eventual price you sell for. The nominal flat fee payable upfront entitles you to up to 6 months of listing time. However, it is non-refundable in the event you opt for early termination. A new listing package must be ordered if you decide to relist after the expiration of your original contract term, or if you decide to temporarily delist and relist during the contract term. Can you customize my listing on various websites? Unfortunately, we do not have any control over how third-party websites choose to display information after they've received the data feed. This means we cannot take custom unit or building amenity requests, request to change listing or building history, request to change public records or other data aggregated by third-party websites, nor any other custom requests on how your listing is displayed on third-party websites. For answers to more frequently asked questions, please visit hauseit.com/agent-assisted-FSBO. Finally, and before we let you go, we want to remind you that this is a low-cost DIY service which does not come with free phone or email support. If you would like additional help, please either consult your attorney or check out our flat fee phone support and broker consulting packages on the Hauseit website. Alternatively, please consider our 1% full service offering if you require more support throughout the process. Thank you for working with Hauseit, and we wish you the very best of luck during the sale process.